Honorable Vice Chancellor of West Bengal State University, Professor Bashup Choudhury, Chief Guest and Honorable President of the Governing Body of Shottopriya Roy College of Education, also the President of the High Secondary Council of West Bengal, respected Uma Madam, respected Principal of the College, Dr. Shubhir Nag, Guest Professor Amit Kumar Bhattacharya, Controller of Examination Bebut Tepa, and Convener Dr. Deepak Kumar Kundu, members of my academic fraternity, distinguished speakers of today's webinar, members of the organizing committee, and my dear students, I always like to address as the future champions of the education world. A very, very good morning to all of you. It gives me immense pleasure today to inaugurate this one day international webinar, and I congratulate Dr. Shubhir Nag and his team for zeroing on such an important and relevant topic as e-learning strategies and teacher stress in post-COVID-19 sessions. I have attended a number of webinars recently, in the recent past, and most of them were based on the subject, like the impact of COVID-19 on the education sector and like that. But I think this topic is very, very much relevant. As the 21st century unfolds, with its emphasis on global concerns and technology, an urge to reconsider teacher education is already felt, and especially when the teaching learning space has witnessed an unparalleled shift during the last 3.5 months in the aftermath of the worldwide outbreak of the novel coronavirus. Just as Dr. Nag has already mentioned, that this unprecedented crisis has mounted pressure on our teachers as well as the learners to make use of virtual space to continue their academic activities. On the 25th of the last March, the news of nationwide lockdown dropped like a bombshell for all the teachers and the students, be it of university, college, or schools. For a fortnight, it was okay. Like it was a sort of holidays for the students as well as for the teachers also. And they were happy. But when it was decided to continue it again for another 15 days, again another 50 days, I started receiving calls, emails, WhatsApp messages from both teachers to their students as well as their guardians, all inquiring when the university will reopen. As this was a crucial time for our education sector, like board examinations, school admissions, entrance test of various universities and competitive exams also that are usually held during this period. So, with schools, colleges, and universities shut across, not only in India, but the whole world, millions of children had to adapt to a new type of learning, that is e-learning. As a result, education changed dramatically. A study shows that all of us, and over 1.2 billion children are out of the classroom. There was no other option but the teaching to be undertaken remotely and on digital platforms. So with this sudden shift away from the classrooms, the academic world is wondering whether the adoption of online teaching will continue to persist post-pandemic, and how such a shift would impact the worldwide education field. Now, needless to say, the pandemic has transformed the centuries-old chalk and talk teaching model to one driven by technology. Even before COVID-19, there was already a high growth and adoption in education technology, with global edutech investments reaching almost $18.66 billion in 2019, and the overall market for online education projected to reach $350 billion by 2025. Whether it is language app, virtual tutoring, video conferencing tools, or online learning software, there has been significant surge in usage since the outbreak of COVID-19. Now, in response to this significant demand, many online learning platforms are offering free access to their services, including platforms like Byju, BYJU. We have often seen, you know, Shah Rukh Khan doing the ad. Bangalore is a Bangalore-based educational technology, which is now world's most highly valued edutech company. There are various online courses like MOOC being run through Swayam, digital e-content through EPG Pathshala, National Digital Library have accelerated hands-on learning through free open source software, etc. So we have seen that. Now, outside companies also are bolstering capabilities to provide a one-step job for teachers as well as students. For example, we have seen that LARC, a Singapore-based collaboration suite initially developed by ByteDance as an internal tool to meet its own exponential growth, began offering teachers and students unlimited video conferencing time, auto translation capabilities, real-time co-editing of project work, and smart calendar scheduling, amongst other features, etc., etc. Similarly, Alibaba's distance learning solution, DingTalk, had to prepare for a similar flux. Now, media organizations such as the BBC are also powering virtual learning. Similarly, the Imperial College London started offering a course on the science of coronavirus, which is now the most enrolled class launched in 2020 on Coursera. My daughter, she is also attending classes of Coursera. Now, our West Bengal government has also taken a noble initiative by utilizing mass media, various popular TV channels, as well as newspapers deploying web technology. So now, what does this mean for the future of learning? While some believe that this unplanned and rapid move online learning without training at all, sometimes insufficient bandwidth and little preparation will result in a poor user experience that is unconducive to sustain growth, while others believe that a new hybrid model of education will emerge with significant benefits. So, however, there are challenges. There are challenges to overcome. Some students without reliable internet access or technology struggle to participate in digital learning. This gap is seen across countries and between income brackets within countries. In a country like India, there's a significant gap between those from privileged disadvantaged backgrounds. For example, under our university, you know that there are almost, I mean, about 478 colleges right now. I have spoken to several principals and teachers and found out that while it's virtually 60% from a privileged background, yes, they have a computer or a smartphone to work on, nearly 40% of those from disadvantaged backgrounds do not. Surveys conducted in even premier institutions like IITs or even in Central University of Ahmedabad reveals that almost 10% to 40% of their students could not access online education or learning materials. So what I'm concerned is that the pandemic has widened this digital divide. Yes, this is the word, digital divide. Yet we cannot deny that e-learning has heralded as a key tool to tide over students' concerns during this pandemic. So what to be done? A multi-pronged strategy is necessary to manage the crisis and build a resilient Indian education system in the future. Firstly, immediate measures are essential to ensure continuity of learning in government schools, colleges, and universities, and we have been doing that. Open source digital learning solutions and learning management software should be adopted so that the teachers find it easy to conduct teaching online. Although our teachers are taking online classes, are using several e-platforms to reach the students, we are holding webinars as recommended by UGC, but amidst this sudden digital shift, the teachers have faced additional pressure of converting like all teaching materials to digital formats. And some of them, they did not have, the required training to handle virtual classes also. So kind of, learning management software should be adapted so that it makes online teaching easier. Several e-platforms with reach across all states in India can be further strengthened to ensure accessibility of learning to the students. Secondly, inclusive learning solutions, especially for the most vulnerable and marginalized, need to be developed. With a rapid increase of mobile internet users in India, which is expected to reach 85% households by 2024, technology is enabling ubiquitous access and personalization of education, even in the remotest parts of the country. So this can change the schooling system and increase the effectiveness of the learning and teaching, giving students as well as teachers multiple options to choose from. Innovative mobile-based learning tools for effective delivery of education should be initiated. Thirdly, strategies are required to prepare the higher education sector for the evolving demand supply trends across the globe, particularly those related to the global mobility of the students and faculty and improving the quality of and demand for higher studies in India. Further, immediate measures are required to mitigate the effects of the pandemic on job offers, internship programs, and research projects. Fourthly, it is also important to reconsider the current delivery and pedagogical methods in schools and higher education by seamlessly integrating classroom learning with e-learning modes to build a certified learning system. The major challenge in online reforms at the national level is the seamless integration of technology in the present education system, which is the most diverse and large. We all know that 15 lakh schools and almost 50,000 higher education institutes. Further, it is also important to establish quality assurance mechanism and quality benchmarks for online learning developed and offered in India's higher education institutions as well as e-learning platforms, which are growing rapidly. Next is that we also need to ensure that ethics and value education should not be left out. Now, anyways, COVID-19 has taught us that business continuity plan is a must requirement for all academic operations. And I believe that the integration of information technology in education will be further accelerated, and that online education will eventually become an